You know, the thing that sets Fortnite apart from any other battle royales on the planet is its incredibly high skill gap, which is of course mainly because of the fact it has building and editing mechanics. And so being able to outbuild and out-edit your opponents has become one of the most important things when it comes to succeeding in Fortnite. So understanding how to use the best techniques is a must. Put your crunch on me, where you at, your motivation guy. That's right, I am back, and today we're gonna be covering 5 of the most broken building and editing techniques that in Fortnite right now. You guys ready for this? Let's get this going. Alright guys, so the first technique that we're going to be talking about today is an old one, and it's because of its age. You know, it seems to be forgotten about over the many years of Fortnite competitive. You know, despite this technique's age though, it can still be an incredibly effective method when it comes to claiming the high ground from your opponents. I am of course talking about the one and only double ramping. So double ramping is when you ramp up, but you also place a ramp behind you to provide you with extra protection from the bullets of anybody taking shots at you while you're making your move. So this is an incredibly simple technique that a lot of players just fail to implement into their gameplay. You know, while there are so many complicated techniques that players can use to protect themselves in Fortnite, you have to remember guys that just because something is complicated and flashy doesn't necessarily mean it's the best thing for you to use. Sometimes simplicity is key. And hey, like if you do want to spice things up, you know, there are always a couple of extra things that you can do. Okay, for start, you can always add in some 90s to really put some vertical distance in between you and your current opponent. And so with the double ramp strategy of taking the high ground, you can also place a cone on the top ramp by looking upwards. And by doing this, you can actually manage to surprise cone your enemy if they're running on top of that ramp. Either way, man, like if this isn't the case, the cone will simply act as an extra added layer of protection from taking damage. If you're struggling to pull off simple tricks like the double ramp and you think you could use a little bit of extra assistance, then you gotta check out Pro Guides courses. You know, from the basics right up to your master courses from your favorite pros like Mongru and Clicks, ProGuides.com has everything that you guys need to improve super fast in Fortnite. Alright, so the next technique that we're going to be talking about today is again another simple one. It's the incredibly famous top corner right hand peek. You know, something that opens up an absolute ton of options to go with, you know, when you're trying to deal damage to your opponent. Okay, so the first way that you can use this edit effectively is by placing a cone right after making an edit instead of just going straight for some damaging shots. When you place a cone into your enemy's box while using this peek, you actually provide yourself with a better angle to hit the player you're targeting. Not only that, like the sudden appearance of a cone in their box is sure to catch your enemy off guard, which could have the result of just making them panic, which can throw off their aim pretty easily. And so while your enemy is spraying and panicking, you can just line up the perfect shot. So, for added protection, make sure you go right into the corner and then jump when using this technique so you can take little to no damage. Alright, so another version of this edit that you can use is, you know, once you've actually completed the edit, you can then put a ramp inside the enemy's box instead of a cone. And so by placing a ramp down inside your enemy's box, you prevent the enemy from being able to escape the box easily. You can then flip the ramp, which will allow you to have another right-hand peek. And with this one, you can easily deal a significant amount of damage without taking much in return. Okay, so the third and final broken way that you can use this edit is by simply shooting your opponent once you just finish the edit. Nice and simple, right? Like all three versions of this edit are incredibly effective and very easy to execute when you're in an in-game scenario to really help you build up some of those muscle memories you need. But of course, Sami, it's time for the question of the day. Okay, so today we want to know what your favorite edit to throw out against your opponent actually is. You know, how do you catch your enemies off guard, you know, with builds and peace control? Let us know in the comments down below and we're definitely going to check it out. All right, back to the video. All right, so the third technique that we're going to be going over today is a little bit more mechanical in nature, but it can be extremely beneficial when you're trying to box up and eliminate your opponents faster. Did you know that you can actually box a player through a window edit? Whew. So to actually pull this off, like it's going to require you to be a little bit more mechanically gifted because you're going to need both to edit and build quickly. However, okay, if you're able to master this move, you're guaranteed to improve massively. All you need to do is open up a window edit, and while your build map is still out, throw down a ramp straight out of that window, then secure your opponent by placing down the surrendering walls. Once the player has been fully boxed up, you can then make pretty much any play that you want. You can reopen your window and then flip the ramp over to use a right-hand peek, like we were talking about earlier, to deal like a lot of damage. You could instead like decide to go for a Mongro Classic and just try to eliminate the enemy if you're feeling flashy. You know, our favorite move, however, is dropping down to one of the walls on the sides and just editing a small window so you can just hit them for a massive amount of damage with the pump while holding a right-hand peek. And so this makes it incredibly hard for them to return fire, meaning the trade will almost always be clean, or if not clean, like definitely in your favor. All right, technique number 4 is actually an incredibly common one that a lot of players are beginning to add to their gameplay in the middle of a fight. So what we're talking about here is actually placing down a cone on top of a ramp when a player drops down next to your wall. So if you're feeling boxed up and feeling helpless when a player drops into your wall, okay, so just stand on top of a ramp, crack open a right-hand peek, and then just throw down a cone. Doing this will trap the player on your wall before they even know what's going on. Okay, so if you don't feel like the right-hand peek is the best edit that, you know, you can do in this scenario, you can also simply open up a small window, either on the right or left side of your wall, and then place the cone through that edit instead. This will make your hitbox much more difficult for your enemies to connect a solid shot on. Again, once the player has been boxed up, the choice of what to do next is yours. Just making sure that, you know, when you're taking a shot, you're as protected as possible. You know, taking a 50-50 after you've done so much work to gain the advantage, it's never a good idea. Because if the opponent manages to win that trade, you're gonna put yourself in a much worse position since they're gonna already be right in front of your wall. All they need to do is just spray to cancel any of your attempts to heal. In other words, play aggressive, but play smart as well. All right, technique 5. Okay, so the final technique that we're going to look at today is something that we've saved until the last for a reason. Okay, so compared to all the other techniques that we've spoken about in today's video, this one is quite a difficult one and may take quite a bit of practice to really pull this off. Okay, so that being said, did you know that you can actually build walls, cones, and ramps through any walls? Yeah, this is called phasing. And in order to do it, all you need to do is just walk up to the bottom right of a wall, crouch, and then as you just stand back up, spam or just ramp a cone. Doing this, you should be able to phase your build straight through an enemy's wall with relative ease. The major benefit of doing this to your opponents is that, you know, you can easily pre-box a player after you force a ramp into their box, either on the left or the right side. This also tends to catch a lot of players off guard. You know, when a player is in their own box, they tend to think that they're safe, unless someone is just actively shooting their wall down or, you know, pushing through with a pickaxe. Suddenly, seeing a cone or a ramp appear in their own build leaves a lot of people seriously confused as to how you've managed to peace control them without even having to break their wall. So doing this obviously has a bunch of advantages, but the best thing is that you don't even need to pull your pickaxe out to swing it at their wall, which could lead to them, you know, right-hand peeking you and just dealing some damage. Remember though, all right, this technique is a bit tricky and it does take a bit of like practice, so try not to get so overly frustrated if you cannot do it right away. Practice, you know, it makes everything so much better, man. So definitely do that for yourself. And I believe in you guys. You got to be patient with yourself. You have to enjoy the journey. We all want to be great and we just can't be great, you know, overnight. It takes time, but you can do it. I believe in you. All right, guys, so those were the 5 most broken building and editing attempts that we think you guys need to try in your games right now if you aren't already. You know, most of these techniques were pretty simple, and the only one that is difficult can be really mastered pretty quickly if you put the practice in. So start using your games, man, and you're gonna bound to see some improvement, man. You can keep going. I'm telling you, I know it's easy to quit, but I wanna let you know, man, if you keep going, the sky is not even the limit. You can go past that. Hey, I believe in you guys. Make sure if you like the video, sub to the channel, and connect to me on my Instagram at Your Motivation Guy. See you on the next one. Peace.